Interesting. I swear I put a lot of time into getting all this to work. Moved to top. Never mind. That's a promising start. That was more like it. Okay. Well, I just downloaded Hi-Rez Info. Because my streaming rig is going a bit crazy. 60 degrees is okay though, and the stream is stable otherwise, so that's good news. Right. Well, any guesses as to what this might be? The stream title is supposed to give a clue, but maybe it's just there to confuse. I actually have never streamed Matisse LN2, and I can't believe that. That's something that just doesn't make any sense to me. So this is going to be a Matisse LN2 stream, and I'm going to check a better chip than I currently have. So I already, of course, I'm not logged in on this bloody thing. I already have all the Cinebenches. So I suppose the important one would be 20. So 5.3 is actually not that great, but here's my bidding. So this is on chip number. I don't even have the chip number noted down. Well, it's on number two, I can tell you. So I'm now on. So here was the airbending results. So number two was kind of middle of the pack, a little bit worse than this five. I think I sold five, or it's missing a pin or something. But this one did okay on LN2, full pot and all that. Sorry, this one, number two, this one. This is sold, but this one was 100 megahertz better for Cinebench and like 1.75 better for Valid. So I'm gonna try it on LN2, like my notes say. I don't really remember how to do any of this anymore though. Okay, so this one full potted. It did. I need to look at my notes. I need to look at my notes before I even turn on the rig. I spent all my time setting up the cameras to the point where I haven't done any of the like OS stuff and all that. Okay, so So 1.8. My results are at 1.8. Okay, so 1.8 vCore, and then I'll do the same. I'll do 1600 FCLK, which this definitely is, right? I'm not missing anything here. So I'm doing sync memory. So I'll do 1600, 12, 12, 12 at 1.95. And I'll try 1.15 for those two. And I mean, SOC as required, but 1.55 or above. Yeah, 1.55 should be fine. So this chip, I think you're meant to be sort of trying 1.2 CCD and 0.9 IO die, but then yeah, I like 1.15. But we can try 1.2, 1.0 as well. Or 1.2, 1.0. As long as I remember, iodide is the one you lower, right? Below stock, or you keep it lower than the other one. I'm giving away all my tweaks here. Anyway. all right, what benches? So let's, before we do anything else, oh, this just bugs me. How do I fucking sign into my, okay. Let's go back into my password manager. Surely I have my fucking HarborBot password correctly saved. Yes, I do. Okay. Thank the Lord. I'm not even religious, but thank the fucking Lord. I think I have the right password here, because it totally drives me OCD that I don't see the best results in the country and in the team and all that. Ugh. Invalid username password. I just don't understand. They fucked it up. They swapped from username to email, and then to email, from email to username, or I just don't get it. I don't, like, why all of this hassle? I'm gonna try all of my saved passwords. Okay, so the first one worked. I don't know what the first one was. I'll have to have a look at my password manager. Okay, so what benches am I trying? I'm also gonna disable this. Oh, it won't even work. Okay. Okay, one more little adjustment here. Okay. All right. Okay, we have country records, we have team records, we have personal bests. Right. 7-zip I already have. Cinebench 2003 I don't give a fuck about. Physics and CPU profile I obviously don't give a fuck about either. 11.5 I still have, and 15 I still have, but that's what I tried hard on because I wanted, sorry, I tried hard on 15 and 20 because those are the only two 62 pointers on that chip. So I'll at least see what this chip does to compare it to the other chip, because I want to sell the worst of the two. So goals are get it to full pot, check what it passes in Cinebench 15, I guess, because that's a shorter bench than R20. Then we already have 23 in single and multi sewn up. I was pretty close on frequency, so I'd probably try frequency next. Especially because, yeah, Psycho I think is inactive. I always like taking records of inactive people. Unless it's a legendary record. It always irks me a little bit when there's a score on the scoreboard that the person doesn't really care about anymore. They sort of have gold, but they don't, you know, maybe they do, but I mean, if you're retired, you shouldn't really care so much about your record standing. So I'll certainly try valid. I'll probably run out of time because I've got to work tomorrow, but, and all the 35 pointers. So I'll write that down here as well. So ordered list, actually. Cinebench 15, valid. 1080p, I don't know if this is really the right order, 4K, there was something else, hold on, Geekbench could be tricky, but we'll try Geek 3 Multi, Geekbench 3, I haven't done like one of these bench throughs in a long time. Let's, 35 points. I mean, I'd probably be happy with that. Next thing to try would be something like WPRIME 1024. And then Y-Crunch is out. Fuck Y-Crunch. WPRIME 32. And then SP32M. I mean, I may not get to 8 different benches, but this is what I want. And always interesting to see 1M as well if I do more than 5.6. But, yeah, okay, I hope that answers your question. Unify X, yes, the only board for AM4. Fuck the Dark Hero. You can see chat history on the raid command. So you recuse yourself because you're a mod? Is that the point you're making, Nick? All right, next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to... Fire up the rig. Here's our pork cam. Isn't that exciting? Why am I hitting delete on my laptop? I'm not going to be able to enter BIOS on my bench rig by hitting delete on the laptop. Okay, guessing what it is. Right. The other issue is, what profiles do I... okay. I have a 3700X profile here. Oh, hopefully it's not a cold profile. Let's double check. 45. Okay, so it's the... That's okay. It's the, like... It's the Airbin profile. That doesn't set memory, though, does it? Okay, we'll have to... Okay, we'll have to set a few things here. God, I haven't overclocked DDR4 in such a long time. It feels weird. Mm-hmm. That may be enough. I'm never sure. What any of this stuff does, basically. Is the long and the short of it. this is great. You get to see how the sausage is made, as they say. Is that sort of the right way off? I suppose it is. Ooh. Okay, we're back in BIOS. No, we need to flip horizontally as well. Yeah, okay, that's more like it. A6, beautiful. Couldn't have done it better myself. As I say. Okay, so now we save that. And we shut down. And now I've got to find an OS that I'm happy with for this kind of stuff. Oh, yeah, I'm not saving over my super secret Heaven OS for Team Cup. So many SSDs and yet never what I'm looking for. Oh, here we go. Here's another pile of SSDs. AM5, no thanks. Win 11. Okay, let's try this 120 gig drive. I'm feeling lucky. I thought I had more notes than that. I thought that was a pretty long session. I must have just gotten lazy or something. All right. I can't believe it's 8 o'clock. I finished work 4 hours ago. That's how long dinner plus setting up the stream apparently took. Doesn't really make much sense, but there you go. And as you can tell, the stream is super prepared. So professional. Live cropping, like postcode displays on stream and stuff. I'm still drinking the watery beer, by the way. Not that I should. Unify. Okay, so let's look at a Win 7 Ultimate. No, we want Win 10. There we go. Macri and Reflect is going away in 2023, 2024, the free version apparently. I'll have to shed a tear, I think. I don't know, maybe I can just use it on like unpatched, like just use the old version forever and ever. I don't know what they're gonna do in relation to that. Like, will they like lock that out somehow? Nerf it, kill it somehow? Restore image. I just couldn't use Ghost or Acronis is such like, what would you even call it? Not vaporware. What's the other bloatware? Such bloatware. I mean, it might here and there have some superior features and things, but just the overall experience just absolutely sucks ass. All right, well, that's restoring. I was wondering actually, since this generation is called Matisse, like, is this sort of thing against the terms of service of Twitch? Like, I'm not going to click on it now because I don't want to risk it, but like I was like, oh okay, how am I gonna name the stream in some sort of witty way? And I was like, oh, I've never benched Matisse LN2, so I've got to reference that somehow. And I was like, oh, maybe I should look like introduce the painter, but I'm like, I can't click any of these pictures because they contain nudity, but it's not real nudity. Like it's a painting, it's not a photograph. And so I don't know, I was trying to read the terms of like a lot of these are fine, but I was trying to read the terms of service of Twitch and I couldn't really. I know that the streamer themselves being naked, I mean, you know, obviously the hot tub streamers and all that skirt that rule, but there's something along the lines of you can't have full frontal nudity, basically, of the streamer. But what about showing pictures of other people? Like, let's say the person was dead or something. I don't know. I don't know. Like, what are all the different scenarios? I've never like considered it. Like these are paintings, you know? Like, I should be able to click into it, but I'm not going to because I don't want to get a strike against my name or something. But then again, I like. Do I have to contact Twitch support for this? Like, I couldn't find it in the terms of service. I thought it'd be easy. I mean, the chat, like, I think my stream, both the stream and the chat are set to intended for mature audiences, but is that enough to keep me safe? I don't know. The mind boggles. Oh shit, the chat window is fucked up. Move to the top. Yeah. Yeah, there's like if you go to I recently had to set up a new laptop and stuff and I had to reinstall Macrium and the website actually only points to the paid version anymore, but you can still download the free installer off of other sites and then still enjoy, let's say, free for personal use Macrium. Using that installer and still getting updates, but when you install it, like there's like a pop-up saying, just so you know, this license, this version of Macrium won't get any updates past like April 2024 or something like that. All right. Let's attach a drive and get places potentially. Yeah, I know. I mean, obviously the install they can't remove the free installer file from existence. That's not really there. Oh, why doesn't this go higher? God damn it. That's not really their like prerogative. But it just won't get security updates and which I guess I mean ah, no maximum set. Okay, let's let's This is something I don't miss from DDR4. There's a lot of things I miss from DDR4 when overclocking DDR5. But this is one of those things that is not part of it. Right, so let's go down to like these sticks should still do that at 1.7, let's say. Why am I upping the CPU ratio? That's also a recipe for trouble. Okay, let's do 1.7. And in the spirit of nudity, let me add a layer because it's winter. What if I did the rest of the stream just like this? Okay, it's not that cold. All right, AD should be boot. Maybe not. F9, what the hell? Think the real answer to this conundrum is clear CMOS, set max mem, then go back to what you were doing. Or just have the system not post at all. Weird. What is that? Time so to pull the CMOS. And the 24. This location. Fuck me. See, 15 is good. 15 is what we want to see. So, anyone following the World Series of Poker? I feel like I've now, in the course of 137 live streams, mentioned about 45 different types of sports. And usually the answer from the chat is, we don't follow this sport. It's like, anyone like basketball? No. Anyone like tennis? No. Anyone following the World Series of Baseball? No. What about poker? What about chess? No. The only sport we follow is benching, apparently. Okay, so we've got both sticks. Is this drive just fucked? I've had issues with this drive before. What, like, why? Like, hang on BIOS clear just doesn't make any sense. Mamma mia, is what I'd say if I was Italian, which I'm not. Oh yeah, I just won't hammer any buttons. I'll just wait for it to do something, hopefully. Okay, so it's booting into OS now. It's showing 49 degrees because it's warming up and there's nothing in the pot. Gonna wait for it to go to desktop. Gonna wait for it to. Okay, so now what we do is, well, we check that it's really MaxMem that was causing our issues. Now, MaxMem is set, so it was the CPU overclock. So now what we need is, I swore I never use Benchmade on stream again, but okay. I'm obviously weak-willed. You caught me, guys. I'm weak-willed. Okay, this thing goes here. Let's just double check that bench descent timings is working. And then new CPU Z shortcut. We don't need the SVD tab, so enable XOC. What's that hang? Don't really get it. Don't really get it. I think this is gonna be a two beer sort of stream. What's okay? I think what may be required is just a BIOS reflash or something. That it's there's something not quite right. Zero D again. I'm not taking any chances. That's it. I'm reflashing the BIOS. Is what I've got on there maybe that modded BIOS? Is that potentially an issue? So there's a new one, the 7D13AA. I'll have to just make sure that we still have like all the voltages we actually need. I use this really, really old, really slow 4 gig. Is it even 4 gig? I think it's 4 gig USB stick. I think it might be like USB 2.0 or a 1.1 even. Just for BIOS flashes because of maximum compatibility with like FAT32 and all that. I mean, I think on balance, if I had to choose to have like an hour worth of issues before pouring versus an hour worth of issues after pouring, I choose this. Because at least you're not wasting LN2. So I can't complain too much. No 0D, please. Ah, fuck you. Where's my screwdriver? I hope my board isn't fucked. Planning to run some iGPU for Team Cup on this. All right. This is it. This is your chance to redeem yourself. I mean, either the board or the chip. It's not the RAM or the GPU. I can tell you that much. I can't wait to switch to this pour cam later on for a bit of pouring action. Ooh, that was weird. Enter BIOS, please. Gonna press the delete button. Oh, F1 to enter BIOS. Fuck me, that's really hidden up there. Okay, so easy flash. M flash is what it's called, because you know it's MSI, so it's called M flash. Oh God. I like this board, but the fact that it's got to reboot to enter fucking flash mode is horrendously pathetic. apostrophe flash, m flash. Okay, I get it. Okay. Things are looking up. Things are looking up. So the file was called 7D13. And it should be from 2023. 7D13. AA. Okay. Hopefully this has all the voltages we need. Is it flashing? Or just, it's just hung. While flashing. I can't exactly pull the power now, can I? The hell? It doesn't have dual bias either, does it? What are these weird hangs? Is this chip degraded or something? I mean, okay, if it doesn't post after this, it's the end of stream, I suppose. Okay, let's look up the manual and check how to do a flashback on this bloody thing. Mflash menu, no, that's not what we want. Flash bias button, okay, I mean, I know there's a flash bias button. Refer to page 59. It's a shame it's not page 69, or else we could make some lame jokes. Da-da-da-da-da. Rename the file to msi.rom. That's pretty standard. No, not this. Other system. msi.rom. Yes, I do want to change the extension. Plug the USB flash drive that contains into the flash BIOS port in the rear I/O. Press the button. Okay. What button is that? What USB port is it? Hopefully there's a nice little diagram that will explain that mystery to us. Okay, flash BIOS button. Flash BIOS port is bottom below the PS2. And of course the mouse is in there because nothing's ever easy. Okay, so we have power. We need to shut it down though. Press and hold. Okay. Well, on other boards you have actual flashing lights on the board itself. Here it's just the button that flashes. So while that's happening, I'm getting my second beer. Oh, it's already booting and telling me it didn't work. Now the file's on there. All right, let's try this again. It's flashing. The USB drive is flashing as well. Okay, I'm getting my beer and then everything's gonna be fine when I get back. That's the plan. I guess. I don't think it's finished flashing at that point, right? Like, why does it have to boot up and scare the shit out of me showing 0, 0? And why doesn't it react to like the power button or anything? The LED will be turned off when the process is complete. Well, what about when it just fucking goes to 0, 0? What does that mean? Piece of shit. Fucking. Right. Don't you dare show a 0D. Junk. CMOS is staying out permanently. That reboot into flash mode, that's what used to happen 10 years ago. Socket clean and remount. Yeah, pull a stick, because I mean, TFW, what does that mean? That feeling, man. Oh, I should have pressed the button to enter mFlash. Because you own a Unify X and you're saying with the death of mine, that would be the last remaining one. I'm a bit slow today. What's the little winter? Oh, charity, okay. Enter flash mode. Is it actually gonna let me flash this time? Okay, so it's slow, but maybe we can get up to MSI dot. Okay, so it's not reading. Oh, don't tell me that, Forks. It sounds like an absolute horror if that's the case. Hey, I'm recopying, and then we're gonna re-enter Flash Utility, and then we'll all h live happily ever after. I wonder if it's still in warranty, actually. Yeah, I generally do kill wall power. The dark side, there's no. X570. Kingpin. I'd probably take that over the Dark Hero. What are these random reboots? That's what I get for thinking, you know, I'll do an easy stream tonight. What I'll do is I'll run AM4 because it's such an easy platform to run. Little did I know. I mean, I could use my Crosshair 7. Is it really a board that's known to die? Like the B550 version specifically, or both Unify X's? Early batch. I mean, I don't know if this is an early batch. How can you tell? Is there like a seriously like a support forums thread about this or something, or a Reddit thread? I bought this secondhand, so I know nothing about this board. Scuttlebutt. So Scuttlebutt is the MSI expert apparently. So AA. Yes, I mean, should I be happy? It's probably gonna fail anyway. 0%. Okay, pray for me. 1%, 2%. We're getting somewhere. I'm getting a beer now. I'm actually getting a beer this time. Well, it's not failed. I should really close that door. Keep the heat in. I mean, also keep the LM2 fumes in and possibly end up in a dangerous situation if I don't open a window. But, you know, when life gives you lemons, make lemonade. Strong lemon crush, pirate life. Cheers. Should I start pouring LN2? 50 degrees on the CPU is pretty concerning. Oh God, this is even worse than the previous beer. Garbage can. You can do it, US. It's a great board when it works. Maybe we need, so there's this the sub icon, emoticon, whatever, sleepy crosshair. Maybe we need a sleepy UX icon as well. Hey, so we're, let's say something positive for a second. I do like the fact that the flash screen on the MSI boards is like much more informative than other flash screens. Like it's like, don't power off, don't eject the USB that I'm flashing off of. It also gives you the CPU temperature in Celsius and in Fahrenheit. It gives you the CPU fan RPMs. So you get, like, to give you an idea of whether or not you could expect the temperature to go up because there's no fan attached or whatever. It tells you what board you're on. It tells you what BIOS you're currently on. It tells you what BIOS you're flashing onto and the build date of the BIOS. And obviously you have a massive progress bar. I think that's like the UX. Okay, that was a bad pun, but the UX of the screen is amazing. All right, 48 minutes in. Can we get our first taste of LN2 before an hour into the stream? Is that possible? I mean, I still need to complete this flash successfully, shut down the system, add a stick of RAM back in, restart the system without getting 0D randomly, go into OS, don't get that hang we got previously, check that maximum is still set just in case, then apply the like really, really basic memory OC that I applied earlier and that didn't work, then go back into OS, maybe run a bench, and then maybe the CPU will be at 70 degrees by then. So I'll be forced to shut down the system and pour some LN2 and see how it goes. So that's the optimal scenario. It'll probably take longer than that. Okay, so just for the record, no poker fans in the chat. While we're waiting, we may as well. Maybe I'll turn some people onto poker. Who knows? No. Is Sang okay? So is Scuttlebutt an actual user on Discord? But am I completely misunderstanding all of that? No, why is my fucking two-way copy paste not working? There we go. Okay, it's not a user on Discord. Okay. Is it a channel on Discord? Whatever. Okay, day four is over. Okay. So this is the top 10. Do I know anyone? Yeah, let's go to the. It's just so for those who are not aware, it's the biggest live, i.e., in person, in real life, poker tournament of all time, not in terms of attendance, but in terms of prize money, because it's a $10,000 tournament with 10,000 entries, 10,049 or something like that. So it's 12 million to first place, 6 million to second place, over a million to everyone in the first eight. I may as well just go into payouts. And the big controversy was, I think the final table of players is considered to be the top nine. And the controversy was, if someone makes this final table and they still don't make a million, like the payout structure is way too top heavy. Like you're outlasting 10,000 people basically, and you don't even get $1 million. But 12 million up top is nice. Almost double first to second is a bit cheesy. That's a bit, yeah, it's not great. Okay, so there's something going on with my board and it looks somewhat promising. Let's go into, we also have to like go into BIOS, check that we have all of our, you know, options that we need. Okay, so expert, do we still have both LN2 modes? I assume we do. Okay, we have both LN2 modes. Do we still have, what's our maximum VCore? Override. 2 volts, that's good. That's plenty. What's our max SOC? 1.55, that's the same as the previous BIOS. That's good. We still have split CCD and IOD. I were to set 0.9. Oh God, what way around is it again? CCD high, IOD low. Okay, so 1.2 and 0.9. That's possible. Okay, good. DRAM up to 2. That's good as well. Right. So our profiles, I guess, are gone. Yes. So we're gonna set this name. Call it LN2 3700X. And we're gonna save to it. Then I shouldn't do any RAM OC until I actually have both sticks of RAM in the system. So I'll shut down cleanly using the button. Let's get our second stick of RAM. Why is it fucking restarting without me pressing the button? All right. Pray for no zero D. Actually, I should boot into OS, check stability in OS, then reboot into BIOS, apply a decent-ish little OC, and then maybe start pouring. It's not the CMOS dying issue. Yeah, load default. I'm quietly confident that the BIOS reflash has at the very least improved things, and as I say that, it's F9ing. Okay. Time for a remount, I think. Just gonna clean everything. Just gonna take everything out, kill power, clean the socket, clean the slots, do all that. Actually, before I do that, I am going to try with CMOS battery unit inserted. Some boards are weird about that. Do something. Board, do something. Okay, I'm checking which LED is on. That might tell me something. CPU, okay. Fair enough. You're forcing my hand, board. You're forcing my hand. Do some on-camera cleaning of RAM sticks. This is like overclocking ASMR. Should I do it right in, like right on top of the microphone so you hear the spray? How was that? If I can't get a rig going, I may as well just ASMR a bit with my cleaning of RAM sticks and various bits and pieces. So the one thing I'll say is I do remember one of my, I think it was the worst, it was the third best chip though that had a missing pin. So if it was this chip, I'm gonna double check it, if it was this chip, which I don't think it was, but if it was, then all of these issues may be explained with the missing pin. But maybe it's just a slightly wonky mode, maybe a bit of dirt in the socket. That's what I'm starting to kind of think might be the case. I hate wasting paste. It's not just the effort of remounting. I just don't like wasting $70 per tube paste.
Yuck. Alright.
I don't see a missing pin, but I'm gonna hit it with some magic spray anyway.
All right.
I've drenched the fucker. Okay. Time to go back to my lemon beer. Okay, so what has happened? The new world records page is live. I think that's worth sort of shouting out. Not sure about this. Communication technology and guidelines. I've not read that before. I don't know if it's been always been there and I've just ignored it. Okay, let's actually, have a look through. CPU profile max is obviously just Fugger on his fucking Cascade or whatever. AIO even on the Sage board. Okay, that's not that interesting. Physics, is that cold? 7.5, okay. Char really benches a lot of RAM stuff, doesn't he? 7.4 in the RAM. Whoa, it's nearly 50K. Interesting, what's interesting about the Cascade? This Takuku guy seems to just only run Threadripper for some reason. I mean, 4.6 at 1.2, and then 3800 C14 quad, that's not bad. Funny that this is the picture for some reason. They should really be showing the valid. Yeah. Oh, I get it. It's the actual only attached picture. So it just defaults to that. Okay, fair enough. Fair enough. XA. Okay, that's not very interesting. So Takayo again on water. So the R15. So people have really stop benching R15 so much to the point that the 2020 is the last time someone actually put up a score on a high core count chip. There's a scale though, like what's is there some way of looking at the absolute world record, any core count? So the Xeon, it's kind of interesting how the Xeon still can't beat the Threadripper, clock for clock, 36 core. No, what was it, 56 core versus 64 core? Yeah, I think it's 56 core, isn't it? Yeah, I'm not imagining things. I thought that would, yeah, okay. AMD must just have an advantage. R23 single bench, single core. Where is that group pick? There we go. Wearing our t-shirts and all that.
That's
starting to look pretty dry. Look, Fugger doesn't make much sense just in general. You don't have to even break it down to his cascade. He just doesn't make any sense whatsoever. All right. I'm going to start to reinsert my stuff into these sockets. Okay. Sticks are looking dry. So let's start with that. Slots looking dry. CMOS battery. Chip. Need to clean off the gunk though. There's one dirty pin on the edge that didn't hit somehow. Leave mains off, but add the 8 pins at least. Cross the hour mark, well and truly. Okay, more world records to look at. GPPi 100M is on the Phi. Let's look at some Phi results. Really, excuse me, scraping the bottom of the barrel here. So this is Xeon Phi on what number, what core count? Can we even determine that? 488 core. That that memory tab is looking rough. 1B is on the Threadripper, obviously. Yeah, Geek is OGS. Wow, 390. So 5.5. What's the memory like on this? This is an hexa channel, isn't it? Octa. Octa. Okay. 6200 C30. Alright. How's it looking, Chip? Nah, that's still pretty wet. I wish I had a hairdryer or something here to hit it with. The Geekbench 5 single core record somehow is on a Xeon? Wait. On DDR3. I don't get it. That must just be... Is it bugged? He's like six times faster than the next score. Yeah, no valid. Is it just the wrong Geekbench 4? Geekbench 4 subbed as Geekbench 5. Yeah. Hey, Strunken. All right.
Right. Chip, behave this time. What a phrase you. Right, let's sit the top. Sit the pot on top. Actually, just even just an F1 for the extra weight and do some stuff. Okay, power's on. Let's connect to the 24 pin. Hit clear. Okay. So it's not powering on at all. Piece of shit. Earlier on, it was powering on without me even saying anything, like pressing anything.
I own a hairdryer, but not. Let me find my heat gun thingy. I can't believe I set up four cameras and I don't know. It's just not going to happen. I've got to work in 11 hours. This is so frustrating. I just don't think I can do anything. I mean, I have a Crosshair 7. Until very recently, I did have a Dark on loan. But it's just, I don't know. This board has just been sitting in a, I mean, what's even wrong with it? Like, I mean, I guess I could pull out my Crosshair 7 and check the chip in it, but that's not really, compelling stream. I think I just have to pack it in at this point. I don't know what else to do. Here's the so-called poor cam. All right. Well, sorry about that, guys. I don't know what else to do. Taking all suggestions, but yeah. I reflashed the BIOS. I cleaned the board. I'm going to let it settle for... I don't think there was even a C... I don't think it was even being stored with a CMOS battery in it. So I don't see what else there is to do with it. I mean, maybe the board is literally faulty, but it just, it's in this weird half-dead, half-alive state. I may just turn on the stream tomorrow. Like, I've got LN2 here, which you can't see, but... Believe me, it wasn't just all a giant fake out. It's there, it's ready to go. I was gonna do an LN2 stream. I haven't done an LN2 stream in a long time. I was really looking forward to it, but if it's just not happening, it's not happening. So, see you in less than 24 hours, hopefully. Apparently everyone except me knows that these boards die randomly. So, okay, learn something. Bye, guys.